Hello and welcome to Talk to Tiger. Today we have a special guest for you. Atri is a good friend for close to a decade. I have seen her fight through several things, including health. The last time I saw, she was in crutches, but she managed to beat that. She runs a lot, does a lot of fitness exercises, and pushes her body and her mind to the extremes. So today I have requested her to join us and tell us about how do we get fit. Most of us are going back to offices and lockdown is open. So we are here to listen to some tips from Atri. Atri, before you start, please introduce yourself to our audience and then we can start off.
Hi, my name is Dr. Atri Nihar Chandra. I'm a naturopathy doctor. I'm practicing last 10 years. I have a graduation and I have an MD in naturopathy. And I have a MSc in food and nutrition. So I'm a combination of both naturopathy and dietetics. So during the lockdown, this is something which I've been telling everybody in my life. Okay, so I'll just say the exact same thing. One is you need to have a routine. Okay, I am many a times criticized for being an Excel sheet person because practically every time I have distributed for my kid, for my house and everything else, you need to have a discipline. That is specifically in terms of eating discipline. Having breakfast by 9 in the morning, having lunch by 1:30 and having dinner by 7:30. Now, in case somebody is awake till 1 o'clock, which is very normal these days because everybody is watching movie or TV. So that time you need to finish your dinner by 8:30. Okay. By 8:30 and why not 9 o'clock? Because 9 o'clock, see, on an average, a food takes to digest 3 hours. Okay. So suppose you have dinner at 9 o'clock, you might end up sleeping at 1 because the food is not going to get digested. So anyone who's looking to sleep at 11 o'clock, they need to eat their dinner by 7:30. You need to finish your food 3 hours before your sleep so that you get a proper good sleep at night. Otherwise, you'll have an extremely disturbed sleep. And there are times it might lead to nightmares also. So every time somebody says that I'm getting nightmares and I'm not sleeping properly, my first question to them is, what time is your dinner? Because if you have not digested your food properly, you'll get all kinds of thought process at night. Okay. So eat proper dinner and finish the food by 8:30 max at night.
Okay.
And it is more like Muhurat. Okay. The way we have Rahu Kal and Shubh Kal and all that. Similarly, for diet or lifestyle, you need to have that timing. 8:30 is not 9 o'clock and it is not 9:30. So maximum anyone with any physical health disorder, they should be finishing their dinner by 8:30, whether it is thyroid, whether it is PCOD or whether it is diabetes or even basic weight loss. Or if you're looking to reduce your inflammation or bloating, or even if you are looking to solve constipation, you need to have food early. Okay. So finish breakfast by 8:30 in the morning. If you get up only at 8:30, there are a lot of people who get up by 8:30 because they sleep by 1 o'clock. Then first and foremost thing is people should first eat their breakfast. Breakfast is one thing nobody should skip. Okay. If you get up at 8:30 also, because your body clock would have started by 6 in the morning. Body clock doesn't stop for anyone. So make sure that you finish your breakfast by 10. In those situations, have a yellaki banana or rhombus banana, but one basic banana to make the body alkaline. Okay, because if somebody is getting up by 8:30, by the time they brush and they feel like drinking water, they will start getting acid reflux in the upper part of the stomach. Okay. And if somebody is having thyroid medicine at 8:30, they have to wait for an hour. There is a cause. Straight away acid reflux or acidity in the body. So in those cases, you need to have a yellaki banana along with breakfast or first thing and then have the breakfast. Okay.
So within 1 hour after waking
within, up, have something. Yeah, but since a lot of people have thyroid disease or have BP medicine first thing in the morning or blood thinners, so in those situations, it is advisable to have something alkaline before they intake anything oily or spicy in any manner or khatta in any manner. See, even idli dosa is fermented. So if you are having anything like that and you are already late in breakfast, this is for people who are not having breakfast by 8:30 but are having breakfast by 10 in the morning. Mm-hmm. In those cases, a basic yellagi banana can avoid acidity. It can help you to avoid constant headache throughout the day. Okay. Second is drink 3 liters of water a day. Okay. 3 liters of water.
The calculation for this yesterday you mentioned.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, 20 kg human being on an average needs 1 liter of water a day.
Okay.
And if somebody is having an average weight of 60 kgs, they bare minimum require 3 liters of water irrespective of the season, whether it is summer, winter, monsoon. Bare minimum 3 is required. Okay. Like my daughter is 2.5 and she's almost 14 kgs. And I can see that she drinks 2.5 liters of water a day. Okay. And if she is drinking 1 liter of water, then I can see her poop cycle change or her bowel movement cycle change. Okay. I keep following a lot of videos and all where people are talking about conditioning, skin, dry skin or dry hair. And everybody is talking about moisturization, but it is still an outer application. Mm-hmm. It is not something internal. Okay. So, and the water intake will vary. जमीन सूखी होती है तो पानी ज्यादा लगता है, गनी जमीन गीली होती है तो पानी कम लगता है, राइट? सो आई करेंटली इवन इफ आई एम 54 केजीज, आई प्रैक्टिकली ड्रिंक 4.5 लीटर्स ऑफ वाटर अ डे. इफ आई ड्रिंक 4.5, माय स्किन इज नॉर्मल, हैज अ नॉर्मल ग्लो. ओके. इफ आई ड्रिंक एवरेज 2 लीटर्स ऑफ वाटर विद इन 15 डेज, यू विल स्टार्ट सीइंग मी हैविंग ड्राई स्किन हियर. ओके. It, the texture changes immediately, then I'll know that I have a dry. In fact, hair fall will start. Yeah, yeah, hair fall will start.
Okay.
I have zero hair fall if I do 4.5 liters of water a day.
Wow.
Okay. So the texture changes completely. You will know. It's like a plant which is like fully blossomed well.
Okay.
And the moment you reduce the water, the hair fall starts. Okay. It's like panjar chalu types. Okay. Third is 8 hours of sleep.
Someone who is about 80 kgs needs to have at least 4 liters minimum.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, water take, huh, so you know that also varies. There are a lot of times people have water retention also. So, because iron, and there are people who are anemic in nature and they don't work out, they're sitting throughout the whole day, they end up having water retention many a times. Okay. So, in those situations, 3 liters is the safest.
Okay.
But, you know, water takes 20 minutes to digest. If you are after drinking water, if you don't pee or urinate after 30 minutes, you can observe. There are times I make people do this when people come to diet for me. I ask them to write down in terms of when they had water and when they urinated. Okay. There are times people urinate after 1.5 hours.
Okay.
Okay. So that's when I calculate, okay, you're dehydrated. And the urine color will change. The urine will be colorless throughout the day. If it is lime yellow or light yellow in nature, then that means dehydrated. Another thing is, if you feel thirsty here,
okay,
that means you're dehydrated. Okay.
Already.
Because, yeah, yeah, because most of people are thinking so much throughout the day that we don't concentrate whether we feel like drinking water or not, unless and until this becomes extremely dry.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so if you feel that this is dry, then water is the thing. And what drinking water is not drinking coffee, and drinking water is not drinking nimbu pani, and drinking water is not drinking coconut water. Mm-hmm. It is water, basic water.
Okay, okay.
Mm-hmm. It is not any other form of liquid. It is just plain water. Okay.
Okay.
Third is 8 hours of sleep, which as a mother we never get. So that's why, like, if you are not getting 8 hours of sleep, at least drink water to stay hydrated. Okay. So I miss those days where I was sleeping 8 hours a day and my skin and hair was so amazing. But 8 hours sleep just makes you poop better, reduces inflammation, reduces bloating. People lose faster. Like, the amount of weight loss happens by just sleeping. It's amazing. Yeah, yeah, it's amazing. Yeah, because if you sleep, you'll auto. There are times you will see that people sleep throughout Sunday because kids are not going to school. So they will get up and immediately go and poop. Okay. There's no pressure of not having a poop, right? So the body needs to be relaxed. So with 8 hours of sleep, a person is very well relaxed. And they will have good bowel movement. I can, you know, there are times I people come to meet me after 10 days and I look at them and I'm like, you're pooping well types. Okay, because I mean, you can see the texture change, hair change, skin change. It is possible to look 10 years younger to your age, provided you poop well. So sleep is the basic requirement. Now, since it is a lockdown, if you have not slept 8 hours in lockdown with your lifestyle, wo na normal lifestyle mein nahi hone wala hai. Okay. So there are times I tell this to people that if you are, jaise, the fifth point which I was going to say is going out in the sun. Okay. Vitamin D should be on an average 60 or 70 in a person's body. Okay. Nowadays, everybody is vitamin D low, and most of the time when people come for weight loss, 99% people have less than 20 vitamin D. So when vitamin D is less than 20, there is clinical anxiety, there is insomnia, there is indigestion. Right. Now, in last 2 months, if you have not gone out in the sun to take vitamin D, then it is not happening. Okay. So a lot of people, when I meet them, they are reluctant towards taking a supplement that is 60,000 international units of vitamin D. Saying that hum log sun mein chale jayenge. I mean, when did you go? When was the last time you went out in the sun? Okay. And वैसे fruit wala should have the or the vegetable vendor should have the maximum vitamin D because they are throughout the day in the sun. But that doesn't happen. It has to be the early morning mild sun or evening 4 to 5 ka mild sun where the sunlight is really mild. You need to spend 10 minutes in the sun and you might like to keep your body in the sun and not the head in the sun. Okay. So just take a good amount of vitamin D. Okay. Otherwise, if you're looking to go for supplementation, one thing I recommend always to people is go for local government, I mean, pharmaceutical manufactured supplements. Okay. Compared to going for beauty companies or private, you know, sector companies, cosmetic companies manufacturing vitamin D supplements, go for a normal sasta tikau 30 rupees vitamin D supplement. They're as effective as the expensive ones. Okay. The local it is, the better it is for Indian climate. Don't go for out of India, you know, international supplements to maintain Indian health. Okay. So but
always take it prescription. Check with the physician.
Yes, yes, of course. So if you are taking supplements, because a lot of people when they find out, they come to me with private companies saying that itne ka supplement or I brought it from US and all that. So I do end up telling people that go for local government manufactured. If you're in India, use Indian supplements. Mm-hmm. Okay. Sabse acha is going out in the sun. So if you are under lockdown, if you can spend that 20 minutes in the sun in a day, it will resolve a lot of mental health issues. And anger issues. Okay. So one of the things people can do is going out in the sun for vitamin D. Fifth point is eating nalakai or amla. That is like my 100% mantra in life. Like my entire weight loss is process is run on amla. I don't know how to do weight loss in other cities because we don't get amla there. Okay. In Bangalore, we are blessed to have 365 days and Nalakai Amla available in the market. Okay. Just eat it like that. It's a very basic fruit. Pungent is a taste. It's an acquired taste. So the maximum benefit of an Amla you will get is by eating it raw. Okay, just like that. Taking a bite and having it. It improves the strength of your teeth. It reduces swelling in the gums, as well as it reduces the pain also in your teeth. If you have any mouth issue, it will go away. Secondly, amla do help for digestion.
Okay.
So if somebody is looking for digestion, there is a lot of bloating or inflammation, or if somebody has piles or fissure, you can practically have 2 nalakai a day. Now, there are times people can't eat nalakai because of the taste. So in those cases, I do ask them to take 2 amla, chop it, put it in a blender, blend it, drink it fresh. Okay. The moment it will change color, the nutritional properties will also change. So it is not advisable to go for packed amla juices in the market. even there are people who are in different cities, they might like to go for amla powder. But again, you know, when the
The fresh it is, the better, you're saying.
The fresh it is, the better. Okay. Mm-hmm. Even so, when I, this is something which I tell all my patients, when the taste changes, the nutritional, chemical, caloric property of the food is completely different. It is not the same thing. Okay. So, amla, salt and chili amla taste is very different than a normal amla juice. Mm-hmm. So, it is not the same thing. It is not going to do the same health benefits. At the same time, when somebody is something is actually converted into powder, the moisture from it is gone. Okay. So the heat property of it increases. So suppose you are eating two fresh nalakais. Okay. If you are coming to an amla powder, then it becomes two teaspoons, not more than that. For the very fact is, the intensity of a powder is much higher than fresh fruit. If you're getting any part of Karnataka, everywhere we get fresh amla. So it's a blessing. I mean, no other city will have amla. So if you are looking for a good hair, amla is your friend. If you're looking for a digestion, amla is your friend. If you're looking to improve immunity, amla works better than anything else. Amla is like the key. So you can definitely have as much nalakai. And even if you have bronchitis, or if you have asthma issue, or you have allergies or cough and cold, then also you can have nalakai. It's not going to aggravate. It's safe. It's not something which is going to create an issue. Last, sixth thing, add 3 cups of vegetables and 2 cups of fruits in your diet. So, yeah, you know, when I'm, there are times when I talk to patients, as a, my daughter listens to rhymes where they are asking children to eat vegetables. In my case, I have to ask adults to eat vegetables. And it is like 3 cups of cooked vegetables, not raw. There are times people come with raw salad and say, "Itna chalega," and I'm like, cooked vegetables. 3 cups of cooked vegetables is almost 750 grams of raw vegetables. Okay, because when you cook, the quantity comes down. So the basic palya in terms of beetroot, carrot palya, or cabbage palya, or basic local vegetables, nol kol, chow chow, jackfruit, you know, raw banana, raw papaya. They're amazing in terms of giving iron and immunity boosting vegetables. And in Bangalore, we get everything which is freshly available. And even in the lockdown, the leafy vegetables, the variety, the texture is still good. And every gated community has 1 or 2 organic sellers coming and selling in the society. That is always there. I love Bangalore for the culture we have in terms of eating fresh. And the amount and variety of vegetables we get here, it never gets boring. So 3 cups of vegetables and 2 cups of fruits. So every time people come and tell me, "You're 35, I want to have a hair like you." 3 cups of vegetables and 2 cups of fruits in a day. Okay. If you're looking to work having a good skin texture, if you want to reduce pigmentation, if you want to reduce wrinkles, 3 cups of fruits, 3 cups of vegetables and 2 cups of fruits is your everyday requirement. Okay. Irrespective, you can have as much protein. If you're on a protein diet, you can do proteins. You can do carbohydrates. That's your diet choice. But anyone should have, who is above 18 years or above 15 years actually, bare minimum need 3 cups of vegetables and 2 cups of fruits in a day. Even when people have diabetes and I'm treating them, that time also tell them that your fructamine goes high if you have fruits after 5 p.m. in the evening. But before 5, you can finish 2 cups of vegetables. So 2 mangoes in a day are safer to eat, provided you finish it by 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So from my side, these are the 6 basic tips for people who are looking to become normal in this abnormal situation and get back to normal living.
In summarize, the first thing you said is have breakfast, lunch and dinner on time, 3 hours before sleeping is when the dinner
should
be. Yes. Second is to have lots of water. In exactly 20 kgs, weight is equal to 1 liter. Safest is 3 to 4 liters a day. Minimum is what you should have.
3 liters a day is very safe to have for anyone.
Okay. Third one?
8 hours of sleep.
8 hours of sleep. That is difficult. But if you get 8 hours of sleep, then it is...
That's amazing. 8 hours of sleep. Yeah, yeah. After 35, I don't know who sleeps 8 hours, but if you don't sleep 8 hours, then drink water. दोनों में से एक तो करना पड़ेगा, अदरवाइज गैस एसिडिटी इज समथिंग नोबडी कैन एस्केप फ्रॉम. विटामिंस
नंबर 4,
विटामिन डी, गो आउट इन द सन फॉर विटामिन डी.
राइट, इन केस इफ यू फील एंग्जायटी, एंगर एंड अदर इश्यूज, वी हैव अनदर वीडियो कमिंग अप वेयर वी विल डिस्कस दिस इन डिटेल, बट विटामिन डी इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, गेट आउट इन द सनलाइट एंड गेट इट. नंबर 5 इज आमला.
नलकाय, यस,
ऐड आमला टू योर डाइट. And Atre is recommending eating 2 at least a day.
The 2 is good. You know, 1 will not have an impact, because if you have severe acidity or constipation, 1 will nowhere be seen in the body. You'll be like, khaya bola tha, kya ho gaya, kuch to hua nahi types. So 2 is bare minimum required as an amla.
And the last one is to add a lot of fruits and vegetables. 3 cups of boiled fruit, vegetables, and 2 cups of fresh fruit.
3 cups of cooked vegetables. See, raw vegetables in Indian climate tends to create gas in the body, especially for people who have thyroid issues. It becomes a little difficult for them to digest. So, see, in fact, if you see Indian culture, all our thalis will have cooked vegetables. We don't have raw as a texture, because we are an equator-based country. We are average having a temperature of 30 degrees. So, raw vegetables are something a little difficult to digest. Cooked vegetables work out very well in our climate.
So, these are 6 tips, and you can reach out to Atri for more dietary and help. And if you especially want to lose weight or get back to your health, Atri has several tips, but only thing is, she's a bit strict. She'll chase you and she'll make you lose weight by hook or crook. So we'll close this video for today. We have 2 more videos we are planning. One is for managing your diabetes, and the other is for anger issues. So we'll see you on the other side. Thank you, Atri.
Bye.